Hello everyone! Today we're gonna discuss about the things to do when visiting the Basilica of Our Lady of Guadalupe in Mexico City. The National Basilica of Our Lady of Guadalupe is the most visited Marian pilgrimage in the world. My husband and I visited the sacred place and we wanted to share you our experience to help you maximize your visit and save you time and money. The Basilica of Our Lady of Guadalupe, the area, is also known as the La Villa de Guadalupe, which means the Town of Guadalupe. So just to give you a synopsis of the sacred place, the Our Lady appeared to Juan Diego to ask the bishop to build a church for her. Then Juan Diego delivered the message to the bishop, but he did not believe him. Then Diego told Our Lady, and Our Lady begged him again to see the bishop. He then delivered the message for the second time, but the bishop asked him to ask the lady for our sign. The Our Lady told Juan Diego to come back the next day to bring the bishop the proof. Juan Diego was not able to come due to his sick ankle. The Our Lady appeared to Juan Diego to assure the illness of his ankle. Then the Our Lady ordered him to go on top of the hill and pick up the flowers and bring it to the high priest. Juan Diego collected the flowers, placed it in his tilma, and went to see the bishop. He unfolded his tilma and the different flowers were scattered and instantly showed the venerated image of the Virgin Mary. So here are the top things to do when visiting the Basilica of Our Lady of Guadalupe. Remember, me and my husband, we don't speak Spanish, but these are the things that you must do. Number one, visit the new basilica. The beautiful new basilica has a modern architecture which on the outside imitates the figure of the Virgin's mantle that protects all her children who come to visit. It can house up to 10,000 people, but it's reduced to 500 during the COVID pandemic. If you are a devotee or not, a traveler or a pilgrim, this place will captivate your heart because of its beauty. Its greatest treasure is the tilma of San Juan Diego, which can be found on the main altar. Number two, attend the Mass. You have to check the main website of the Basilica of Our Lady of Guadalupe for the Mass schedules. There is a Mass almost every hour daily, and I believe the last Mass on weekdays is at 7 p.m., which we attended and we consider the most serene due to less people. All of the Masses are in Spanish. Although we do not understand entirely, it is still one of the most memorable moments for us to celebrate our faith among with a wonderful community and to see the tilma in the altar during the Mass. So this is a must do. So reminder, please wear appropriate clothes to show respect. And make sure you come at least 20 minutes or maybe earlier before the Mass starts so you can form in line to enter the new basilica. If you want to be near the altar, you need to go in line in the center or in the middle of the church, and there will be a lot of people. Anywhere you sit, you will be able to see the tilma. Number three, witness the image of Our Lady in the tilma. Near the tilma. So the tilma actually represents a beautiful image of Our Lady's pregnancy, and which represents the living presence of Jesus. This can be visited up close in the back of the church. If you are a believer, this can be the highlight of your visit. During the COVID pandemic, the friendly staff checked our temperature and to clean our hands with sanitizer. They did a great job of putting rows of moving pathways to prevent the crowding of people beneath the tilma. We visited during pandemic, so we visited the tilma several times, but during normal operations, this can be crowded. make sure to prepare yourself, so a prayer, your camera, video cams. And this is the moment where you want to slow down the time while witnessing the sacred dilma. Number 4, place a petition. Immediately after the moving pathways, take the left hallway. You will see a glass windows where you can place your petition to be included in the mass. We paid 100 Mexican pesos for the petition. So the church lady doesn't speak English, but she is so helpful. Since we can pick up some Spanish, it helps us a little bit to communicate. If you want to place a petition here, please click the link below. Number 5, light a candle. This can be found in the back of the church of the new basilica. So you can buy candles in the souvenir store, inside or outside the church. You'll see a lot of people, a lot of crowds, and the candles just go quick. Number 6, visit the different chapels within the La Villa de Guadalupe. So one chapel is the expiatory temple to Christ the King. This is the chapel that houses the Tilma for 262 years. This is known also the Old Guadalupe. Number 2 is the Parroquia de Capuchina. This is the parish of Capuchin. It is a convent for the Capuchin of nuns. Another chapel is the Capilla del Posito, which is known as Posito Chapel. It is where you can find the well where the water flowed. Another chapel is the El Cerrito del Tepeyac, which is the Hill of Tepeyac. This is where the first apparition of the Our Lady to Juan Diego, and this is where he picked up the miracles of roses. Next is the Antigua Parroquia de Indios, the Indians' old parish church. This is built in 1531, and this is the first place that nests the Tilma. Juan Diego raised sited here to protect the holy site. So those chapels are actually different churches besides the new basilica in the La Villa de Basilica. Next one, buy souvenirs. Of course, we love to buy. We love to shop. So there are 3 religious goods stores inside the La Villa, but we recommend the one in the corner behind the new basilica. This is the biggest and the price is decent. So we prefer buying religious items in the main church gift store because then it provides financial support to the church. They accept cash in pesos, credit or debit card. Our Lady of Guadalupe outside vendors is also a choice. So the outside vendors, there are lots of vendors and souvenir shops outside the basilica. Some of them accept credit or debit card, but they do not accept US dollar bills. The local store vendors on the top of the hill is also a good choice. Actually, for us, it's the best one. The La Villa near the El Cerrito del Tepeyac Chapel, which surprised us for the price. Unfortunately, they only accept pesos, and the price here is way cheaper than the local vendors outside the La Villa. If you need Mexican pesos, there is an ATM machine inside the La Villa, which is near the back entrance. So we use our debit card and we had no problem with drawing pesos. Wish we knew this because we tried different banks and money exchanges, but they asked for our passport, which we actually left in our hotel. So I would suggest bring pesos, Mexican pesos. So next thing to do is, of course, after shopping, you want your religious items to be blessed by the priest. So this blessing occurs several times of the day and some of it is continuous. It can be found at the left side of the new basilica if you're facing the basilica. So it's near the entrance where you would want to see the tilma. So the guests just line up with the religious items, then while the priest continues in blessing with holy water. It's fun to watch because the priest even get you wet and you're blessed. So this is a must thing. Next one is visit the museum. The entrance fee is minimal, 10 pesos. So expect to spend about 1 hour to 2 hours in the museum. Here you will find about the history of the Our Lady of Guadalupe Basilica, as well as the culture and history of Mexico City. And the last one, take a guided tour. Me and my husband did it on our own, which we were fine, but you may choose to get a guided tour. The Basilica is offering a group guided tour for free. Unfortunately, this was not offered during our visit due to COVID pandemic. You can also book a tour from different private companies if you want to know more about the area, then spend more time on your own in La Villa after the tour of Our Lady of Guadalupe. But if you want to save some money and also to maximize your time, then I suggest you can do it on your own. But I know if we don't speak Spanish or if we don't understand Spanish, sometimes guided tour is also beneficial. Bonus tip, if you have more time after visiting the Basilica of Our Lady of Guadalupe, there are so much things to see and do. There are Mayan ruins, there are historical places, good food, downtown, and so much to do. There you have it. So those are the things that you must do when visiting the new Basilica on your own. And thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave some comments. And also, please don't forget to like our video and subscribe to our channel. Till next time!